Welcome to the Marwood Stories New Unselected Press Conference. It's my pleasure to introduce writer, director, producer Noah Baumbach.
Somehow get that information at a young age, and we, it's a partnership. And that's very, a big example is with, you know, with his character. And I think that's a road we were trying to, you know, get into.
Thank you. Okay, let's open it up. Where is Mr. James with the microphone, please? Do you want to come to the center? Okay, I see Carly Newman. Wait until you get the mic. Thank you. And don't be shy, people. Introduce yourselves.
I'm Carly Newman from Close Up Film. It's a lovely film, really well directed and beautifully acted. But the title is not terribly attractive. It's also very long if you have to do a shorter review. Who chose the title and why?
That's the best question we've ever asked.
That was very good. The original was Yentl 2. Right?
Yeah. It's still tangled up in a lawsuit. You don't like the Meyerowitz stories, New and Selected? No?
Okay. Yeah, we started off in a bad note right now.
I did a play of Arthur Miller's called Death of a Salesman, which is, you know, kind of a classic. And we had more than one conversation where he could not get anyone to produce that play, because every producer said, we'll do it, but you have to change the title. No one wants to go see a play called Death of a Salesman. We want to discover that, you know, that he dies. And Arthur said they didn't understand, and that was, I want them going in knowing they're going to watch someone dying. So I think he has his own. Or, I think that it's, you're always trying to do something fresh to hold an audience's attention. And I think it's all through Noah's work. You know, this is family. Yeah, you know, that's all we see, you know, or used to see, you know, in the golden age of, you know, movies. Family, family, family. How can you tell it in a new perspective? How can you hold an audience? I think that's just in you.
Thank you. We have a lady here.
Hello, I'm Lindsay from A Different Kind of Woman. Hi. How believable did you find the characters? Were they based on your own life? And how relatable did you find them to play? The family, the relationships in the family.
I thought you were going to say, I hate the movie, but I love the title.
Let me just jump in. My father passed away a long time ago. My mother passed away a long time ago. Noah's family is alive, and I think it's natural for him to be somewhat judicious in terms of answering questions about yours. Do you know what I mean?
Well, all my movies are personal, you know, and there's a distinction between personal and autobiographical. Made a movie, The Squid and the Whale, which is people right out of the gate assumed was, you know, my story or something, and I did use sort of a lot of elements from my life in that movie, but it was total fiction at the same time, and you know, so I think the same is true here. I mean, these are, you know, it's taken from all over. I mean, I'll steal or borrow from whatever works for the story, you know. And you know, I made a movie, Frances Ha, which, you know, was about a 27-year-old woman sort of figuring out her life, and that felt equally personal to me as The Squid and the Whale did, or this movie did.
Here, can we get the mic to the chap on the aisle in the fourth row? Thank you.
Thank you. Hello, hi, I'm Alessandro De Simone from Italy, from Gioia. I have a question from Mrs. Sandler. You've been one of the first great stars that embraced the Netflix new way of producing movies. And I want to know why did you decide to have this close relationship with Netflix, and how is working with them?
They've been great to me, and they've been allowed me to be free creatively, and it was just really close with Ted Sarandos and the whole team. It's an exciting place to be right now for me. They just the enthusiasm is gigantic, and they love what they're doing, and they love getting the movies out there, and they're very never seen anybody more excited about a movie than this movie. They love the Meyerowitz stories, and they're just excited to get people to see it, and there you go. Been very nice.
Yes, can we get right across the
aisle?
Lovely, thank you.
Hi, Philip Detlefs of DPA, German Press Agency. Following that, so would you say that working with Netflix gives you more creative freedom and more possibilities to actually produce projects than you would have with the traditional studio system in Hollywood?
They've been great to me. I don't know that, you know, there's other ways to do it, but this is the way I'm doing. My relationship with them has been great.
Is there a question
there, please?
Hi guys, congratulations on the film, Russ Nelson, Red Carpet News. My question's to Adam and Dustin. Obviously you've had the pleasure of working together before, and I think it would be really nice to hear from both of you the qualities in each other that you most admire as performers, because we love seeing you together.
Thank you. I love Dustin's incredibly encouraging, and he's concentrates on his own work, of course, but he's all about the entire movie and about everybody's performance, and was is as thorough with his other actor as he is with himself, I think. I mean, it's just a great person to be looking at during a scene, and you feel like your partner wants you to do the best you can do.
Dustin, also, I'd say, just even though you didn't ask me, is so, I mean, you know, he's so thorough and asks so many questions and sort of just so open to exploration with his own character, but he also is that way, as Adam's saying, about everything, and will even point out things about the script. You know, he sees the movie, and he's a great storyteller, so he would say, like, you know, maybe will people understand this and this and this and this, and there were scenes he wasn't in. It was just about, you know, making the best movie possible. He'd be a great dramaturg.
What does that mean?
I don't know. Somebody on a play.
Dustin, you have thoughts on Adam?
Oh yeah, and then I'll say something nice about him.
Well, you go first. I have to plumb my memory and see if I come up with one.
What I'll say about Adam is, as we were saying, we all prepared a lot and talked a lot, but as a director, in many ways, part of your job is to, you know, see the actor and see what they're doing and help guide them. But with the best actors, you know, there's this other thing going on that is out of your control in the best possible way, because they're drawing something from inside them that's a mystery, and it might even be a mystery to them in some way too. But they're, you know, but Adam connected to something very deeply in this guy. It's something we haven't even talked about that much, but I would marvel, throughout the shoot at just how true and unacted it seemed. It was behavior, and it was deep, and that was, it was very moving to me.
More?
Or should I keep going?
I'll wait till you finish.
I also liked when you punched up Bob Barker. Happy Gilmore.
Yeah.
He started it. Okay.
Take two. Yes, that's what I was
talking about.
When we started the film, and I was, you know, doing stuff with Adam, and also there were things he was doing with other people, but I happened to be on the set, and I observed it. Noah uses the word deep, and I think what that means is, this is my personal feeling, I don't think actors should play parts unless they're in it. Otherwise, it looks like they're performing a part. Oh, so-and-so is an asshole, but I'm not an asshole, so I'll just perform an asshole. I'll just get a few people in my head that I know, real people that are assholes, and I'll just do that. I think we have the asshole in us, all of us, and we have, and it's up to us to enlarge on that. And I thought what Adam was doing, because I couldn't put it into words, I agree with Noah, there was something about him that I had not seen before, and I know him, and I'd done another film with him. And I went home and I said to my wife, I said, I think Adam has hit a part of himself in which he would be the person that didn't make it. And that's, you know, that's as close as you can get to the bone. And I thought that's what Adam was doing, that's to hit that. Because we can, we all can, you know.
Beautifully said. Was that a hand for it? Yes. Can we get the mic to this? Thank you.
And Dusty, likewise, you were just an asshole. You weren't playing.
Well, that's what's wonderful about being an asshole, is that there's so many varieties that you can do.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Marvin. I'm from the Philippines. Hello. And I run a social media channel called Posted Showbiz.
Congratulations.
Thank you. It's my first time to be on the festival, and it's my honor to be here in the London Film Festival. My question is something to do with social media, because I manage a social media channel. And there's one generic question that I'm asking everyone that I had the opportunity to interview or attend a press con on, and forgive me for my question. So my question requires you to answer either take it or leave it. I should be handing on the props to you, but it's too far and I'm too shy. So the question is, I'm a film student, has been bashing your film on social media as a mere trash. Are you gonna take it or leave it?
Is this hypothetical or?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, on social media, sir, I'm
making it. Who is this?
Made up person.
You have to either take it or leave it. You can't
just
be. Yeah.
I think you just gotta leave it. I think you take it and leave it.
Yeah. You take it, you get annoyed at yourself, and so then you decide to leave it.
You know what? Let me just leave it.
Yeah.
But I took it and it felt right.
And I'm afraid we're going to have to leave it there, but if you'd like to take some photographs, now's the time. Gentlemen, thank you so much for your time and for your insights. And here we go with the pickies, and I'll get out of the way.